Table 5, we're going to cover the epithalamus. Now, how it kind of lays out in the brain is that we have, well, I kind of picked the wrong side, so let me switch. So the epithalamus would be here, the thalamus is here, and the hypothalamus is over here. So in the epithalamus out here, we have this guy, which is the pineal gland that we see exposed on the outside, but it actually is a gland that wraps into the thalamus. So on this sagittal view on a real brain, here we can see the pineal gland kind of sticking out here. Here's our thalamus, and then here's our hypothalamus. If we're looking at a whole brain, I'm gonna have to lift up the cerebellum to see inside, but I'm gonna have Suzette come image in here real close. So right here, this little tongue, it kind of looks like a little tongue. This is our pineal gland that's going to wrap into the thalamus. But here we have our epithalamus. So it's going to go in there, but there we can see it. Then on our thalamus, we have what's called the interthalmic adhesion. Now on our real brains, we didn't cut this at a good angle, but the interthalmic adhesion would be found right smack dab in the middle. On our model brains, we have right there, interthalmic adhesion. Our hypothalamus, we have a couple things coming off. So our hypothalamus, we have the mammillary bodies. This view doesn't show it super hot, but then we also have the infundibulum. Now the infundibulum attaches to, here we go. Here's our infundibulum. Comes off and attaches the pituitary gland to the brain here. So here's our hypothalamus, and then we're attaching to that. So on here, we can kind of see this infundibulum coming off. We don't have a pituitary gland on the real brain, but then below we see one mammillary body. When two mammillaries are together, mammillary bodies, they kind of look like little brain boobies, is what I like to think. And they do. Mammary glands sound very similar to mammillary bodies. So here we have the two mammillary bodies right next to each other. And then we don't see the infundibulum on this one. But here you can actually see the hole where the infundibulum came through right there. Now, pituitary gland, I showed you on this brain right here. There's our pituitary gland. Now our optic chiasm, we have this X that kind of comes together. We just see the base of the optic chiasm, this white center right here. And we can kind of see it coming off right here. But really what it looks like is when they're together. So these are our two optic nerves coming out. As they come together in that middle, that's the optic chiasm. And then as they go back into the brain, those are called the optic tracts. So our chiasm is this part, and the infundibulum will come off kind of in between there and attach to the pituitary gland. Third ventricle would be found. So here we have the thalamus kind of has two bulbs. So we have one on this side and one on the other side. And the third ventricle kind of hangs and hovers in the middle surrounding that interthalmic adhesion. So on this side, you can kind of see part of how that third ventricle, this is part of the thalamus on. So the interthalmic adhesion is right in there, but we can kind of see how that third ventricle circles around in between one bulb of the thalamus and the other bulb. On this little model, we can kind of see in gray how that third ventricle works right here, where there's a hole right smack dab in the middle where that interthalmic adhesion would run through. So that's our third ventricle. Now the midbrain or mesencephalon, we're gonna go back to this underside here. We have what's called the corpora quadrigemina. Now my brain is upside down. We know that because the cerebellum's on top. So don't get confused by my wordage because the brain's upside down. So it's not gonna be the direction we're thinking. But we have the corpora quadrigemina, which are these four bumps. Now, I know in your thing it says tectal plate in parentheses. These four bumps are on the tectal plate underneath this, but that's not ever gonna be what we're pointing to. The four together are the corpora quadrigemina. These two are technically on bottom because remember my brain's upside down. So these two are the inferior colliculi, and then these two bumps are the superior colliculi. And then our cerebral peduncles, we're gonna go to the front here to see those. Peduncle stemming from the word ped or foot. So here's our pons. But at the bottom here, we have these two guys. I'm gonna have Suzette angle that a little different there. So we have this guy and this guy, which are the cerebral peduncles, or the feet of the cerebrum. And following that, here's pons. And then beyond that is the medulla oblongata. And then we hit cerebral aqueduct and fourth ventricle, which you best see from this view. So this actually has all the ventricles together. So beyond this, this is our lateral ventricle in here. And you remember our third ventricle kind of went through here. Then here's our cerebral aqueduct, also called our mesencephalic aqueduct. And then we go into the fourth ventricle, which is right by where the pons is. So if I were also to lift up on the brain and go in between the medulla and the cerebellum, right in there, that's also where the fourth ventricle would be found. And then lifting up in here, this area in there is where the third ventricle would be found. So different ways to go about and see the different things.